What's up guys, this is AK and today we're talking about Notebook LM, Google's latest AI tool powered by Gemini to help you take better notes. This can change how you research, organize information and digest it. To start off, I'm going to share with you guys step by step how you can get started with Notebook LM and whether it can fit in your workflow. And then to build on it, I'm going to share with you guys some use cases so that you can get the most out of Notebook LM. So without any further ado, let's jump right in. To access Notebook LM, a simple search should lead you directly to their website. However, I'll leave a link in the description below. The availability of Notebook LM as of the recording of this video is still limited, so do check to see if it's available in your country. Click on Try Notebook LM. And now you should see some example notebooks which can be useful if you're new to the website. Or you can create your own one, which we're going to do for illustration purposes. You can have one notebook for each topic or subject area that you're researching on. Notebook LM is unlike any other note-taking app, which is why it may seem a bit confusing for a beginner. So let me orientate you to the workspace. On the left, you have a panel where all your sources reside. So how Notebook LM works is that you can upload PDFs, Google Docs, Google Slides, or simply just copy and paste text, which Notebook LM then extracts information from. One source can have up to 500,000 words, which is a far bigger context window than any AI tool I've seen. And it's free. How this differs from other LLMs like Gemini is that it doesn't use information from the internet. It uses what you've provided and then links it in a way that's useful to you. For any learner, it's important to make connections, whether it's between different sources that you're reading or past knowledge and something you're currently reading. Notebook LM helps you do both. Alright, next you have this text box. This makes Notebook LM feel a lot like Gemini. So you can ask questions based on a topic you're researching on, and Notebook LM will look through your sources and give you a synthesized answer. Lastly, you have the notes panel. Any comments you have or any guiding notes for yourself can be typed out here. So let's see this in action. I'm going to use the notes I created from the book 21 Lessons for the 21st Century by Yuval Noah Harari. Right off the bat, you can see it gave me an abstract summary as well as some suggested questions. And these aren't your generic questions that pop up with every PDF. These are context-based. So to kick things off, I'm going to ask, what does the author say about the future of jobs? And Notebook LM is going to scan through my notes and pull out all the relevant information for my query. And you can see it has given me quite a long answer. So these numbers that you see, these are actually references. So if you click on them, they take you directly to the portion of the source this was taken from. Moving on, I can ask, will AI take over our jobs? And once again, it gives me a pretty relevant answer. However, if you ask something that's completely off topic, it will tell you that the source material mentions nothing as such. So if, for example, I ask it, what does the author say about how we should manage our finances? It will inform you that there's nothing in the sources as such. Now let's say you've made a sudden realization and you'd like to take something down. Just click on Close Chat and you'll go back to your notes panel. Now click on New Note and type out anything you like. I'm going to use my favorite quote from the book. You can edit the note in the future if you wish, or you can select it and you have all these options. So you can ask Notebook LM to help you understand your thoughts better or critique them. You can even ask it to generate an outline and it'll try to explain your thoughts better with examples. Obviously, you can also delete a note by selecting and hitting delete. So those are some basic functions, and with that, you're ready to start using Notebook LM. Now let me give you some ways this can be used in your daily lives. Say you just attended a meeting and took down some notes, or you received back a transcript. Sometimes they tend to be really long, so instead of going through the entire chunk of notes, what you can do is upload them to Notebook LM and directly ask it for the key points. It'll synthesize the notes in a couple of sentences, saving you a ton of time. Of course, you think twice before uploading anything confidential onto any website. However, the thing about Notebook LM is that Google doesn't use your sources to train the AI model. Another way you can use this tool is in writing. If you're writing a book or an article, Notebook LM can really help you pull information from a lot of different sources and blend it in a way that has your style and your voice to it. So I have an article that I wrote here. Now I can ask Notebook LM, please suggest how this piece can be improved. And it has given me plenty of suggestions. Now I can say, please rewrite this article in accordance with the suggestions that you have given me above. Let's say you don't have an article in the first place. You're looking for ideas, something to research on. What you can do is upload your notes. In my case, I'll be using my book notes from earlier, and then ask it for angles that you can pursue. So I'm going to say, please suggest related ideas or avenues of research related to this book. and it has produced a whole list of essentially rabbit holes that you can go down. Another use case that I can think of is book notes. And this also brings me to the second part of my tutorial, which is using multiple sources in one notebook. So what I'm going to do is upload notes that I've taken down from a couple of finance books I read earlier and ask questions based on that to deepen my understanding. Let's start off with something basic like, what does EPS mean? Right off the bat, I noticed there's something missing here, but I'll talk about that in the later part of this video. Regardless, it has given me a pretty relevant answer. Though it doesn't give me the formula, it describes the formula in words. Let's try something else, like, how does company culture affect business? Not bad. But if you read through multiple books and you're still not clear about the basics, you've wasted your time. On that note, let's move on to more advanced questions. How does Benjamin Graham feel about index funds? Is trading better than long-term investing? Now, it has given me this really long answer showing which one is better according to the sources. And you can see it quoted the investment guide and common sense investing. What it doesn't do is provide two sides to an argument. So in this case, it only tells me why long-term investing is better and says nothing about how trading can be better. It's both good and bad. That means it's sticking strictly to its source material, but it also may lead to confirmation bias. That brings me to some of the pitfalls with Notebook LM. So obviously there are a few things that are missing from this tool, but do take note that this is just an experiment and not a full-fledged website. Number one, unlike Gemini, it doesn't have multiple drafts. So if you ask Gemini literally anything, it would give you three drafts for the same answer, whereas Notebook LM only gives you one. Number two, you just can't, for some reason, press Shift and Enter to go to the next line. Probably just a bug, but I'm just nitpicking at this point. Number three, you don't have the option to regenerate or stop generating. So let's say you accidentally entered an incomplete prompt. You just can't stop it from generating an answer. You have to wait for it to finish and then type out the entire prompt again and then get an answer. Minimally, an edit option would be nice. And that sums it up. Now you know the basics of Notebook LM and how to apply it in your everyday life. I hope you found this video helpful. Drop a like if you did, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already for more such videos, and make sure to check out my other videos. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.